So let's get started by going over how to use the MACD indicator for technical analysis. The MACD indicator shows both the momentum and the trend of a stock using its moving averages. MACD stands for Moving Average Convergence Divergence Oscillator. It consists of the MACD line, the signal line, and the histogram. On a day chart, the MACD line is the difference between the 12-day and the 26-day exponential moving averages of the stock price. The 9-day signal line is the exponential moving average of the MACD line itself. The MACD histogram is the middle line with the vertical bars on either side and is calculated by subtracting the signal line from the MACD line. The MACD can be a very helpful tool for finding both entry and exit points when trading. There are multiple trading strategies that you can use with the MACD indicator. You could use the signal and the MACD lines to implement a crossover strategy for buying and selling. When the MACD line crosses above the signal line, this is a bullish signal for trading. When it crosses below the signal line, this is considered to be a bearish signal. You could also use the zero line on the MACD chart as a signal to buy or sell. When the MACD line crosses above the zero, this could be a buy signal, and vice versa for the sell signal. Above the zero line, the stock is likely in an uptrend, and below the zero, it's likely in a downtrend. But remember that no single indicator or candlestick pattern is ever 100% correct, so it's important to confirm any signal with other indicators. If there was one indicator or pattern that worked every time, I would think that everyone would probably just use that one. But until that's discovered, let's take a look at how to apply and use the MACD on a candlestick chart. So now let's go over how to apply and use the MACD indicator on our candlestick chart. To add the MACD to your chart on TradingView, let's click the indicator icon here and search for MACD. The MACD is a momentum indicator that can be used in multiple different ways, but my favorite strategy is what I like to call the MACD crossover strategy. The MACD line here is the difference between the 26 and 12-day exponential moving averages. The signal line is the 9-day exponential moving average. Using both the MACD and the signal line, you can implement a MACD crossover strategy that can be used to identify entry and exit points. When the MACD line crosses above the signal line, this is considered to be a buy opportunity. When it crosses below the signal line, this could be a good time to either sell or to go short. The histogram here simply shows how far away the signal line is from the MACD line. So let's say you were holding this stock and you wanted to sell before this downturn here. If you were using the MACD, you could see that the MACD crossed below the signal line here. This would have been a sell signal using the MACD crossover strategy. When you see the MACD line go back above the signal line, this would have been the time to re-enter. You would have held your position until the MACD line crossed back below the signal line right around here. As you can see, the MACD crossover strategy is actually pretty accurate and one of my favorites to use for trading. The MACD crossover strategy actually works even better if the stock is less volatile. If you would have purchased at this crossover here at the beginning of this uptrend, you would have seen a few bounces off support levels, but you would have held on to almost the very top of the rally until we received another crossover signal. So for this trade, we would have purchased around $185 and sold around $225. Not too bad if you ask me. Not only can the MACD crossover strategy help you capitalize on strong uptrends, but also save you from holding during strong downtrends as well. You can see that after this stock had a massive rally, it also had a massive decline. But if you were using the MACD crossover strategy, you should be just fine. You can see that after the crossover sell signal, the stock price went on a massive decline, and the MACD line stayed below the signal line, which you can also tell by the histogram being shown at the bottom of the center line instead of at the top. You can see the prices start to bottom around here as the MACD and the signal line both start to flatten out. After the MACD line crosses above the signal line and holds for a few days, you can now re-enter. You can also look for divergences between the MACD and the price movement to help identify trend reversals. The MACD line typically follows the price movement pretty closely, but if you notice here right before the massive decline in the stock price movement continued to go up while the MACD line diverged and started to move down. This is known as a divergence. It can be a great indicator that a trend reversal is coming. You can see that right after the divergence occurred, the stock price quickly followed to catch up with the MACD. So that's a brief overview of how to use the MACD for stock trading. It's one of my favorite indicators, and I hope you'll give it a try. I'll see you in the next video.